Hello students, so in the last lecture we have already completed up this conditions part, okay, which conditions are necessary for the germination. In today's lecture we are going to continue with the chapter, okay, of the seed structure. But in today's lecture we are going to perform of the experiment on the basis of water, temperature and oxygen. See, we have already studied about these conditions, but we have to prove okay, whether these three factors are only necessary for the development of the seed into a plant. So now it's an experiment time. So our first experiment, as what was the first condition? The first condition was related to the water. So we are going to start up with the first experiment, which is related to the water only. We have to prove that the water is necessary for the germination process. So see students, we have to take a two beaker, that is beaker A and beaker B. Okay, inside this beaker B, just notice one thing. This is a cotton, which is whitish in color, we can see out here. Okay, this hole is a cotton, but this cotton is quite dry. Okay, now again, this is a cotton, and if you look it carefully, it is bit wet. Okay, the effect of this wet is bluish in nature, bit bluish. So that it can create up the difference for you. So the main difference is about the dry and the wet. In beaker A, some seeds were kept, and in the beaker B also, there were some seeds were kept. After some hours, in a day or two, not in hours I can say, in a day or two, we can see the seeds, okay, which were kept in the beaker A, didn't germinate. Okay, didn't germinate. Okay, they are the non-germinated seed. We can't see any of the shoot part growing up. Okay, but as you can see in the beaker B, this was the seed in the start. After 2 days, it started to germinate, and after few days, it germinated with a big shoot system. Okay, we can see out here. So this says that the water is quite necessary for the seeds to get germinate. Okay, so who is going to absorb this water? Okay, who is going to absorb this water? Thus, the water will be absorbed by the hilum. And I already completed this part. Okay, this is a seed. There is a whitish scar, and on the top there is a small hole. Okay, which allows the water to come in, and because of this the the seed swells up, and when the seeds get swell up, so it starts to germinate. So the main difference would be dry and the wet part. Now the second condition was related to the suitable temperature. So we have completed this part. Okay, so what is the minimum, means the optimum amount of the temperature which is required for the seeds to get germinate? That is around 25 degrees Celsius to 35 degrees Celsius. Okay, this was the proper or a optimum. Optimum means a favorable condition in which the seeds can germinate fast. Now let's perform this exercise. This is a beaker A and this is a beaker B. Okay, inside this beaker A, first we are going to discuss the condition related to the beaker A. Inside this beaker A, we can see this white color ice cubes are kept, as we can see out here. These are the ice cubes which are kept inside this box. Okay, and the box is closed. Okay, now as there was some of the seeds we can see out here has been kept. As we can see, some of the seeds have been kept. After a day or two, we can see that seeds didn't germinate. Okay, so they have been proved to be a non-germinated seed. But in beaker B, if we keep, okay, see, there is a what cotton wool, okay, here. We have kept the seed out here. Okay, now this seed is kept in the air part, okay? It is kept in the normal temperature, okay? Not too high, not too cold. It has been kept on the moderate condition. So we can see that the seeds have start to rupture after a day or two, okay? Okay, I just wanted to give you a condition. In the beaker B, see, the seed can germinate also, okay? But the seed will show a sign of germination after many days, okay? Within a day or two, it won't show any kind of a sign of germination. It will need around 7 to 8 days in beaker A to get germinate. But in beaker B, it will start to show up the sign within a day or two, okay? Now the third question was related, the third condition was related to the oxygen. So we have to prove that the air is necessary for the germination. Now there are two flasks has been kept, that is flask A and flask B. In the flask A, first see, I'm going to mark this for you. In both of the flask, wet cotton wool has been kept, okay, and the seeds have been kept, which has been perfectly soaked, okay. The seeds are not dry, so the seeds are perfectly soaked up, okay. Now there is a test tube which has been inserted inside this flask, okay. How it has been inserted, actually it has been tied with a rope, and the rope has been kept out here. And this is a cork which has been fitted so that this test tube doesn't falls. Okay, this is something like this. Okay, it is not hanging in the air. So we can see there is a difference between those part. In the beaker A, flask A, they have kept the plain water, but in the flask B, there is an alkaline pyrogallic acid. Okay, see why they have kept the plain water and why they have kept the alkaline pyrogallic acid. I just wanted to show up a difference to you. See, water is perfect, both of them are kept in a suitable temperature, so two of the condition got favored. Okay, there are three condition in all, that is the water, temperature and oxygen. Okay, oxygen or air also you can call. See, two condition have been favored. See, this is wet, the water, the both of them are kept in the same temperature so that we can prove the exercise. Now the third condition, which is related to the oxygen. Inside the flask A, they have kept the plain water, and inside the flask B, they have kept a solution which is known as the alkaline pyrogallic acid. After few days, in the flask A, the seeds will start to germinate, okay, but in the flask B, the seeds won't show any sign or a very slight amount of germination. It is going to show a bit or no sign of germination. So why this happened with the flask B? Because inside this test tube, as we can see, there is a special solution which has been kept, that is the alkaline pyrogallic acid. The property of this alkaline pyrogallic acid is to absorb all the oxygen which is present inside this flask. See, if this is a flask, so definitely there would be a presence of the air inside this, okay? Suppose there would be the presence of air, but when they kept this alkaline, so the air which is present inside this flask has been absorbed, okay, by this acid. And because of this, the seeds got two of the condition, that is the water and the temperature, but the third condition, that is of oxygen, have not got these seeds have not got this oxygen. So that's why they showed up the sign of there was a slight germination or no germination, you can call. Okay, so this proves that the oxygen means the air is also necessary for the germination part. बट वाई दे हैव केप्ट दिस प्लेन वाटर सो दैट दे हैव टू प्रूव के वेदर दिस इज द फंक्शन वॉट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ दिस अल्कलाइन पायरोगैलिक एसिड. ओके सी दिस प्लेन वाटर हैज डिड नथिंग बट दिस अल्कलाइन पायरोगैलिक हैज अब्सॉर्ब द ऑक्सीजन सो वी कैन प्रूव ना कि दिस सोल्यूशन विल अब्सॉर्ब अप द अब्सॉर्ब ऑफ ऑल द एयर विच इज प्रेजेंट इन साइड दिस फ्लास्क. ओके नाउ अ थ्री बीम सीड एक्सपेरिमेंट. दिस इज क्वाइट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ओके एंड दिस इज इंटरेस्टिंग एज वेल. सी दिस इज अ वुडन प्लैंक. दिस इज अ वुडन प्लैंक एज वी कैन सी आउट हियर एंड इन साइड दिस एंड देर आर थ्री दे हैव टुक द थ्री बीन. ओके द एक्सपेरिमेंट इज रिलेटेड टू द थ्री बीन तो दे हैव टुक द थ्री बीन. वन ऑफ द सीड इज इन साइड द वॉटर. वन ऑफ द सीड इज इन द एयर कंप्लीटली इन द एयर एंड वन ऑफ द सीड इज हाफ इन वॉटर एंड हाफ इन एयर. तो सी दिस पार्ट ऑफ द प्लांट इज हाफ इन वॉटर एंड हाफ इन एयर. दिस इज गेटिंग ओनली वॉटर. दिस इज गेटिंग ओनली एयर. तो वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट द कंडीशन दैट ऑल द थ्री फैक्टर्स आर हाईली डिपेंडेंट ऑन ईच अदर. ओके वी नीड प्रॉपर अमाउंट ऑफ वॉटर, वी नीड अ प्रॉपर अमाउंट ऑफ एयर, वी नीड अ प्रॉपर अमाउंट ऑफ अ टेम्परेचर. तो वॉट हैपन्स सी फर्स्ट आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट दिस पार्ट सीड इन साइड दिस वॉटर. दिस पार्ट वॉट हैपन्स वेन द सीड इज इन साइड दिस वॉटर. सी एंड द टेम्परेचर हैज़ बीन केप्ट कॉन्स्टेंट सो यू डोंट हैव टू थिंक अबाउट दिस पार्ट. ओके द टेम्परेचर इज क्वाइट सूटेबल फॉर ऑल ऑफ द थ्री बीइंग एक्सपेरिमेंट बिकॉज दे हैव बीन परफॉर्म ऑन द सेम डे एंड ऑन द सेम प्लेस. तो टेम्परेचर हैज़ बीन फेवरेबल फॉर ऑल ऑफ दिस. दिस सीड दिस फर्स्ट has got the water and the temperature but it does not got the proper amount of oxygen so that is why the seed which is present inside the water didn't germinate. Okay this was the first. What happens in the second? See the temperature is favorable and it is getting a proper amount of the air but this seed is not getting up the water because as we can see this wooden plank this seed which has been kept is in the air so it is getting out the two condition that is the temperature and the air but it is not getting the third condition that is of the water so that is why it is also not going to germinate this seed. See as I already mentioned these three seeds have got the suitable temperature so you don't have to ask up a doubt regarding that part. So the temperature is favorable. Okay this half seed is this half is inside this water and this half is above the water means in the air. So this seed was getting a proper amount of all the three conditions so that's why it starts to germinate. Okay and this is a very famous experiment, three bean experiment. Now as we have studied about the germination part so we have to study about the two types of germination that is the hypogale germination and the epigale germination. So what do you mean by hypo? The first one is the hypo. The word hypo means below and the word gale means earth. The word epi means above and gill G-E-A-L gill is the earth. Okay so first we will understand the terminology part. Hypogill means below earth and epigills means above earth. Let's see up this part. So this is a diagram which is going to help you out to understand this part in a more perfect way. The first condition is epigale. What do you mean by epigale? Above the earth. To see See, this was a cotyledon. This cotyledon started to, this seed started to germinate. This was a cotyledon. And this cotyledon is above the earth. We can see out here. Okay, this cotyledon is above the earth. See, where is the cotyledon? This cotyledon is above the earth. How we can say it is above the earth? Because it is the surface, okay? And this cotyledon is above the surface. This cotyledon is above the surface. C means the cotyledon. So that is why it is called the epigeal germination. Okay. But what happens in a hypogeal solution? Hypogeal germination. Hypo means below, gill means earth. See, we can see up this cotyledon. See, it started to germinate. Okay. And then this cotyledon, this is the surface and this is the cotyledon. Okay. And this cotyledon is present below the surface of the earth. Okay. We can see this cotyledon is attached to the root system, this root system. So that is why it is called the hypogeal. Hypo means below, okay, below the earth, because it is below the surface, okay. And this was above the surface here, and this was below the surface. So this was the two type of a germination. Now, see, as we have completed this, as we have completed this epigeal germination and hypogeal germination, I just wanted to make you understand one of the terminology related to the both of this part. See, where is the cotyledon? Here. So I'm going to write C. And where is this shoot is starting from? Here, na? And where is this cotyledon? It is here, below the surface. And where is this shoot? Exactly above this part. So what we can see? Here, the C means the cotyledon is above the shoot system. Okay, here the cotyledon is above the shoot system. So that is why it has been called as epicotyle. Because the word epi means above and cotyle means cotyledon. Epicotyle means, epi means the above and cotyledons. Cotyle means the cotyledon. The cotyledon is above, right? Here the cotyledon is below. So that is why it has been called as the hypocotyle. Why hypocotyle? Because the word hypo means below, cotyle means the cotyledons. Okay. In the hypogeal germination, the cotyledons remain in the ground. Okay. And the shoot systems elongates. Okay. The shoot system is elongated. In epigeal germination, the cotyledon pushed above the ground. Okay. See, it has been pushed, so that is why this cotyledon has came up. And the region, okay, the shoot system is below this part. Okay. So here we can see the cotyledon is above and the shoot system is down. And here we can see the cotyledon is down and the shoot system is up. Now, who show this epigeal germination? This epigeal germination is shown up by this bean seed. Who showed up this hypogeal germination? This hypogeal germination is showed up by the pea. Okay, these are the example. In exams, they ask you, okay, who shows you the hypogeal germination? That is the pea plant. And who shows up the epigeal germination? That is the bean. Okay. Even the maize, even the maize shows up this hypogeal germination. Now, viviparous germination. This is the third type of germination. We have already completed these two types of germination, that is the hypogeal and epigeal. Now we are going to learn about this viviparous germination. But this is a very special kind of a germination. this viviporous germination you won't be able to see in any of the it is not possible to see in all the plants. Okay, this type of germination is shown up by the special plants only. Okay, this special mode of seed germination is shown in the special plants only. The two examples I just wanted to give, that is the rhizopora. This is the rhizopora. This rhizopora is a mangrove plants. Okay, where does this mangrove plants are going to, we are going to see this mangrove plants, we can see in the damp and the swampy places. Okay, damp and the swampy places means the land which is without the there is no land, okay, only the water surface, we are going to see in that part this mangrove have been grown. And this kind of a germination is shown in the rhizopora and sonaracea. Okay, now first we will discuss what do you mean by the word viviporous. The word viviporous is a special type of a term. Okay, here we can see this we can see in the tomato also. This is an example of a tomato also, but according to your syllabus you should write the sonaracea and rhizopora. This is the only explanation part, so that's why I'm giving you as a tomato, but you do in the exams you don't have to write tomato. See, inside this tomato we can see inside the tomato there are many seeds. Okay, so what happens when these seeds get the favorable condition inside this, so they start to germinate. We can see, so the word viviporous germination means the seeds which germinate inside the fruit while it is still attached to the parent plant. See, what we usually do, this is a tomato suppose, and these are the seeds, and if we provide them these seeds get the proper amount of conditions, so they can start to germinate, right? This is the basic condition. But inside this, suppose this is a tomato, and inside this the seeds. Okay, when the seeds which are present inside the tomato get of the favorable amount of the conditions, they start to germinate. Okay, and they are still attached to their parent plant. Okay, they have not been detached. Okay, they are inside this only. So this is called as the viviporous germination. The word viviporous you have already heard in your lower standards. Viviporous means producing live young ones. Okay, that means giving birth to the young ones. There is an oviporous also. What do you mean by oviporous? Which gives egg, like how the hen gives the egg, and inside this egg there is a little chick. Okay, but viviporous means giving a birth to the young one, as in the condition of a humans. We don't give egg, we give a birth to directly the young one. So that is why this special name has been given to this part, that is the viviporous germination, because it gives the germination condition inside the plant only. Now we are going to learn about the seedling condition. You see, before starting of the seedling, let's understand this diagram. See, what we are going to do, we are going to insert a seed first, and we are going to provide them the favorable condition. And when we provide them the favorable condition, it will start to germinate. It will convert into a sprout. But when this sprout means a condition which is not fully developed. But when this seed gets convert into a seedling, so it develops into a new plant. We can see, suppose this is a soil surface, we can see a proper amount of a root system, this is a shoot system, and we can see the leaves also out here. Okay, we can see the proper amount of the leaves also. So let's understand what do you mean by seedling condition. Then seedling is a stage in the growth of a plant from a seed. Okay, so as I have already said, okay, there was one seed, it started to germinate, and when it germinated fully, it got developed into a new plant, no? So this is nothing but the condition of the seedling. Now from a seed, before it has become wholly independent of the food stored in it. What does this line means? Now see, this seed has developed into a plant. Now this got the proper amount of leaves. Now it does not have to take the help of the endosperm to make a to take up the nourishment. Now this plant can manufacture up its own food with the help of the leaves, because we know this photosynthesis, where this photosynthesis get occurs, this photosynthesis occurs in the leaf part. Okay, this leaf takes up the sunlight and then the photoreaction happens inside this leaf, and this is how they can make up their own food. When the seedling get developed more, okay, and becomes a mature plant, it start to produce a flower, and that flower will turn the ovule into a seed, and in its turn means the procedure is going to happen. Okay, this is a seed condition, germinated seedling condition. Okay, this is a seedling condition, and now from this a mature plant will take place, and the mature plant will give rise to a flower, the flower will give rise to the seeds, and this is how the hereditary function, okay, the hereditary function or the next generation takes place. So this was all about the seed structure. Thank you, student. This was the part 2.